Good morning, students. Today I will give you a basic description of the definition of the artificial intelligence, which is very much important. In this video, we are going to cover the problem of artificial intelligence techniques, and the tic-tac-toe problem. So, what is the artificial intelligence? The artificial intelligence is basically a problem of the computer science. It's a branch of a computer science which is dealing with the few intelligent problems, smart machines, and which is mostly capable of doing all the tasks which is required the human intelligence. Basically, in the machines, what is happening? Every artificial intelligent device is having few intelligent techniques which is embedded by the human being only. So basically, the human intelligence are being embedded in the artificial intelligent systems. So the artificial intelligent techniques are used to solve those problems by the computer, which can be solvable by the human being, but the computer can help to solve it in minimum amount of time. So what is the difference between a human and a computer? The human can solve any problem at any situation, but a machine cannot. For solving the problem, the machine should have the algorithm which should be given by the human being. If that system or that method is not been given in the machine, then the machine is incapable of solving the particular problem. As simple as that. So human can create any mathematical model to solve any problem, but a computer cannot create a mathematical model. Computer requires a mathematical model to solve a problem. Without having the mathematical model, the computer cannot solve any problem. Okay. So how the human intelligence can be implemented in a computer program? The intelligent machines can be easily written by using some programming language, but the logic is being created by the human being. So the program which is being created by the human, that is being run by in a machine so that the computer can be a little bit more smart. Remember one thing, computer did not create human being. The human create the computer so that the computer can perform such problems or some solution of some problems within a fraction of moment. But it is not like that it can replace a human being. Okay. For example, suppose we want to multiply 41 into 81. Right. So if we do not have a multiplication sign in a computer, which what can be a solution? Either we can add 41 81 times, or we can add 81 into 41 times. So which one is more optimum? The optimum is process 2. Yes. Why? Because 41 times we are adding some number, but in process 1, 81 times we are adding. So optimum solution is the process 2. So we need to identify which number is smallest and which number is largest. The smallest number should be the number of addition, and the largest number should be the number within the second bracket. This model can be created by the human intelligent, but the computer cannot process it. Human has to give the model, this mathematical model, into the computer to multiply this operation without the multiplication sign. So human intelligence is more powerful than the computer, and the computer can get the intelligence from the human only. So what kind of problems requires the human intelligence? Four kind of problems are there. For example, optimization problem, prediction problem, exp- expert system and natural language processing. So optimization problem is the problem which can give a optimum solution like minimum or maximum value. Prediction problem is not following a particular method, it is predicting a optimum solution. Expert system deals with a database with some rules and corresponding action, and the natural language processing is using the method of understanding various languages through the computer. Okay, so method for writing an intelligent program is to know the problem first is very important. Without knowing the problem, you cannot solve it. Correct? So if you know the problem, if you know what kind of input parameters are there, then you can suggest some steps, intermediate steps, which is defined, which is limited steps, not the infinite steps. Based on that, you can write the program for solving it. So solving the optimization problem is basically following two processes. The first process is the conventional process, which takes a defined and finite time, right, which is given mostly in all the books which is available in the market. And another technique is the randomized program, which is basically dependent on the hypothesis. It is a nature inspired algorithm. For example, genetic algorithm, artificial neural network, fuzzy system, etc. So hypothesis can be anything. The hypothesis can have the loopholes, or the hypothesis can have some profits. Let us take some example of this hypothesis. The question is, a teacher have to select the best set of students from a class of having 60 students. And what the teacher generally does, the teacher selects the set of students, good students, based on their CGPA, right? So how many comparisons are required? Suppose 10 set of students we want to select. So we have to know, the teacher doesn't know who is earlier records, the teacher doesn't know. So teacher, the teacher will do, the teacher will take the CGPA list and compare all the CGPAs and select the best 10 students. And for that, he or she has to do 60 comparisons. Right? But the hypothesis can be like this also. The hypothesis can be this, that the teacher go to the classroom and tell to all the students to raise their hands who are having the CGPA of more than 8. Right? So here the students who will raise their hands, the teacher can easily get their names and CGPA. Suppose 15 students has raised their hands for the more than 8 pointers. So what the teacher will do, out of those 15 students, he will do the comparison and select the 10 students. Right? So only 15 comparisons are required at this moment. So which one is the better? Obviously the testing of hypothesis is better, but the loopholes can be there. Suppose some students were not attentive at that moment and he or she didn't raise his or her hands. So that may be a loophole, but we can ignore in case of urgency. If we want to get the urgent solution, so we can go for the hypothesis, right? So the hypothesis can be changed also. Suppose if we ask to all the students to raise their hands and only 5 students raise their hands, so we can change the hypothesis and we can ask to all the students to raise your hands whose CGPA is 7. So that can be changeable. So based on your hypothesis, you can get any optimum solution at any moment and in a optimum amount of time, right? So this is how the randomized algorithm works. Few conventional algorithms in artificial intelligence are 8 puzzle problem, tic-tac-toe problem, waterjug problem. It is there in the syllabus. We will go through this. The one problem is the tic-tac-toe problem. The tic-tac-toe problem, we all know. What is the tic-tac-toe problem? The tic-tac-toe problem is having the 9 blocks where it is basically a 2-ply game where player 1 can take a cross sign and player 2 can take a zero sign, and one after another they will give the movement. First player 1 will put a cross sign in any place, then the player 2 will put a zero sign in the rest of the empty places anywhere. The condition is the player who will win the game, that who will get continuous 3 signs together in horizontal way or in the vertical way or in the diagonal way, then he or she will win the game. So basically this is a state space tree of the tic-tac-toe game, where first time the first player will get a 9 blocks to place the cross sign, then 8 blocks will be remaining, then the second player will give 8 blocks to give the zero sign. So in this way the game will on. So for the first time the player 1 will have 9 options, in the second time the player 2 will have the 8 movements, then again the player 1 will get the 7 movements. So this is how the state space of the tic-tac-toe problem can be drawn, but every node, so obviously it is not possible to draw within a copy, so I'm showing it to you in this way. So basically who will win, who can be more intelligent, that they can give a movement in such a way that the other player will not be having any option, right? So this is way the tic-tac-toe game can be played. In my next video we'll go for the next chapter. I hope you have liked this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel for getting the more video options. Thank you so much.